Hi there, welcome back. Today we will talk about 2 steps to score A in your A-level computer science exam. This video is for you if you are confused or not sure on what to study for the upcoming exams. For example, some of the students who are taking my crash course always come to ask me whether this topic X is important for the exam or this topic Y will appear in the exam. And next, if you struggle to apply or remember the knowledge that you learn from this A-level computer science subject, let's say you spend a lot of time to study or revise but the knowledge doesn't seem to sink in. And lastly, this video is for you if you want to score as high as possible for your upcoming exam to get the best grade to get into your dream university. And without further delay, let's go into step 1, which is active recall using official syllabus. First of all, just do a Google search and search for A-level Computer Science 9618 syllabus and then just click on the first search result. And once you are inside, you can just download the syllabus based on your sitting. So right now, I have my iPad open. On the left is the syllabus and on the right is my notes. So let's look at how can we do this active recall using the syllabus. So if you look at this right now, it's actually showing the first page of the syllabus. We will just scroll to the page whereby it shows the detailed information for every chapter. And now let's just do the scrolling. So let me just scroll to the first chapter. Where is it? So here you go. So this is the first chapter under subject content. And how can we do the active recall based on this syllabus? So it's actually quite simple. You can just think of all the candidates should be able to, as well as the notes and guidance are like the prompt or the questions for you to answer. And now I will be picking some examples and let's do together. For example, let's do this perform binary addition and subtraction using positive and negative binary integers. Show understanding of how overflow can occur. So how do you answer all this prompt? You can just try your best to recall as much information as possible based on the prompts. For example, binary addition and subtraction. What can you think of? For example, I can think of 8 bits number. Then maybe adding another 8 bits number. And maybe I'll get some carry here. And then I'll be just doing some addition for this binary addition and subtraction. And definitely when we talk about subtraction, we can think of 2's complement. So for example, let's just give yourself some example. For example, 00000010 minus, let's say, 00000001. So how do you do this binary subtraction? So first of all, you can change this minus to plus. So how do you do that is that you can just do 00000010 plus the 2's complement of this number. And how do you get 2's complement? You can actually get 2's complement by reversing the bits. And then plus 1. So here you go. So this is how you can do the binary subtraction. So this is just for you to recall. And next, show understanding of how overflow can occur. So for overflow, we can always think of the maximum positive number as well as the maximum negative number. So what would be the maximum positive number for 8 bits 2's complement? So we can just draw something like this. For example, overflow. And then we know that 8 bits, so it's going to be 8 bits here. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8. So for maximum positive, it's gonna be 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. This is for positive. And then for negative, it's gonna be just 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. So any numbers that fall outside this range will result in overflow. So this is how you can do the active recall based on these 2 prompts. So I hope you enjoy the live demo and you'll be able to do it on your own. You can just go through every single question and prompt in the syllabus as you do your revision. And if you can answer 95 to 99% of the question, you are good to go to step 2. So you can just do like me, whereby you have your syllabus on the left and then your blank notes on your right. And then you try to answer all the prompts inside the syllabus on your blank notes. You can use your notebook, your tablet, or even your whiteboard if you have one. Definitely, you will realize that this active recall take a lot of time and effort to complete. But trust me, this is way more efficient than any other study techniques that you apply. If you're stuck in certain prompts or questions, you can find the answers from my YouTube video as well. And now let's go to step 2, which is doing past year as soon as possible. So some of you might like to spend a lot of time to do the perfect fancy notes for this subject, or trying to read the whole textbook inside out, or try to memorize every single fact for this subject. So don't do that. Just start doing the past year as soon as possible. So as I mentioned, before doing the pass here, just do step one, which is active recall first. And once you're done with the active recall section, you can start doing the pass here. For this Cambridge A-level computer science papers, there are 9608 papers, which are the old syllabus, as well as the 9618 papers, which is the latest syllabus. So I will highly recommend you to complete all the 9618 papers first before start doing the 9608 papers. By the way, if you are not sure where to download the latest paper 1 or paper 2 pass year, you can use my free link in the description down below. So how do you start with your pass year? In general, I would recommend my students to do the first or second attempt using open book style. It means that while you are doing your first or second pass year, you can use your textbook, your lecture notes, or even my crash course as the supplementary materials. This is to familiarize yourself with the pass year and look at how the pass year are being marked and how all the marks are being awarded. So after doing the first attempt, you can start doing a pass year like the actual exam. You can go to a place with no interruption and set the timer to mimic the real exam duration. For example, 1.5 hours for paper 1 and then 2 hours for paper 2. Then you can start doing a pass year without any disturbance. After that, just mark the pass year yourself based on the official mark scheme and you can try to learn, improve or adapt from there. So just keep repeating these steps and you should be good to go for the actual exams. In conclusion, start with active recall using the official 9618 syllabus and then start doing pass year as soon as possible. And while you're doing your pass year, you can also refer to my video here or my crash course for more pass year walkthrough. Thank you and I will see you again then. Bye bye.